Hello, learners. I am Dr. Rakhi Narula. Today, I will give my presentation on model lesson plan. Now, we start with what is a lesson plan? A lesson plan is a guide which helps execute a mission that is to be accomplished in the classroom with the children. A lesson plan can also be defined as a creative process which provides a framework for purposeful learning. How to make lesson plans? A classroom has two important elements. First is teacher and the second one is student. Both are at the receiving end of knowledge acquisition in the sense that both acquire and enhance knowledge together and both are always in the process of learning. Other elements that are important in a classroom are textbooks, lessons, examination, experience the children get, and the expectations of the parents, etc. It is important to keep these variables in mind when you prepare a lesson plan. Lesson plan maintains both rigorous planning and flexibility. Firmness is important to ensure that teaching objectives are met, and flexibility is important to ensure the real difficulties met while teaching. Therefore, the teacher needs to keep a plan in mind that has firm objectives and leave enough space for last-minute adjustments. In order to stay focused, the teacher must write down the objectives that he must accomplish in the class and lead the class with gradual incremental progress. Although she may have to change the classroom activities depending on the classroom situations. Let us see how to prepare a lesson plan and how to divide up the lesson, keeping the language acquisition goal in mind. Number one is class timings. The teacher must first know how many teaching days and teaching hours he is getting in the week and in the year to complete the course. The length and duration that you are getting per lesson will help you to achieve your teaching objectives very well. The teaching hours and teaching days of the entire year will help you to design lesson plan for the entire course with an aim to complete the course with its desirable objectives. Second one is class size and age group of the children. Third is title of the chapter. Fourth is prior knowledge. It is important to check the prior knowledge of the children because the issue of prior knowledge must relate to how you plan to proceed further with the plan towards the completion of your teaching objectives and learning objectives. Fifth one is common objective or general objective. This is the overall objective that you want to achieve through the lesson. Sixth is specific objective. These objectives relate to day-wise plan as it aims to explain what happens in a class in a particular day or period. Seventh one is methods or process. The method is about the line of progression in the class, about the chapter, keeping the general as well as specific objectives in mind. Next is self-evaluation. Just leave the space vacant. The teacher must fill this out after the class evaluation of his or her teaching. He has to write here what went right and what went wrong in the class and whether the intended objectives was achieved or not. This should also help you to figure out why you had to make changes to the lesson plan in the class. Ninth, suggestion or remarks. This part helps you to make a note of your own experience in the class and helps you to adjust the activity you have planned. This helps you to investigate the viability of the rest of the plan based on the success of the first day's teaching activity. Now, I should give you example or model lesson plans. Let us now look at few lesson plans and investigate and analyze the methods involved in those plans. These plans are from different contexts, and thus let us see how does the teacher take help of these lessons for her or his use and what does he ignores. We will also see how well the teacher created basis for class participation or ignored it, and which aspect of teaching learning objectives he or she has tried to achieve. Model lesson 1, that is Tulika's class. This is the lesson plan of a class 2 teacher called Tulika. Let us look at her plan and analyze the model. Tulika is a primary school teacher in a school at Kalyanpur in rural Bihar. That school has village at one end and a jungle at the other end. Farming is a major occupation of the people living there. Some parents work in the town as masons, rickshaw pullers, carpenters, vendors, etc., and they visit home once a week. Most of the children spend time in helping their mothers in the crop field, taking care of other siblings and cooking, etc. Most of the children have illiterate parents, and some have semi-literate parents who have studied up to primary school or at the most high school. Children of her class do not have exposure to newspapers, magazines or books, etc. Tulika teaches a batch of 30 in class 2. Children speak Bhojpuri at home, whereas the medium of instructions for them is Hindi at school. The children can recognize all the letters of Hindi alphabets is how they can read few words, but they can neither read fluently the storybooks they have been given, nor they can understand the sentence properly. This example is taken from a textbook that she teaches to such a batch. The name of the story is Sacha Mitra, which is the 10th chapter of Bihar Board Class 2 textbook. Tulika realizes that she has to teach the lesson by speaking to students in Bhojpuri as well as in Hindi. She is also sensitive to the fact that children are likely to use Bhojpuri when they answer to her questions, and she does not have to forbid them from using their first language or shout at them for the same. She believes that making small groups in the class can make children help one another to understand the text better and learn better. She also understands that she needs to give importance to reading, writing, speaking, and listening skills and make them happen in the class in a meaningful way so that the children can understand the text, context, and make progressive growth towards learning the language. The story is about two friends who meet a bear while returning home. She decides to start the class by discussing with children the kind of animals they know about, because she knows that the children would know about animals from the environment. She has to complete that story in a week, and every day she teaches for 35 minutes. She read the story twice or thrice before she went to class. Her teaching objectives and lesson plan had the following points. Number one is engaging the class with drawing activities. Next one is giving them opportunity to speak to each other and to the teacher about the story. Next, giving them the opportunity to talk about the picture, and then making them read the story by understanding the story. And then making children write down the names of the animals. After that, letting children predict the end of the story. And then making them talk about the animals they see in their surroundings. After this, we will discuss about her day-wise plan. That is, on first day, she familiarizing children with the names of animals around them in written form process. First step she did that, asking children to write down the names of the animals they see around them. Then telling them to write down the names of the animals they see around them, draw their favorite animals in the copy and encircle the name of the animals they see on their copy. Then she make them read out of the names of the animals written on the board, adopting the language game method, and make the sound the specific animal makes. Then on second day, developing prediction skills among children process. Then she did leaving the children with the story for some time to observe the three stories given there, making children give presentation on the story and showing signs of appreciations. Then making the children predict in the middle of the story, writing down all the prediction on the board. Then on third day, story completion process, taking the predictions given by the children process. First step she took was reading out the entire story aloud and bring those words to board that children are very familiar, like gaon, bhalu, football, mitra, dadi, mu, naak, murda, ram, sham, etc. Then making children write down these words on their copies, making children encircle the words gaon and football on page 1 and repeat the same process in the last paragraph of the third page with words such as muh, kaan, naak, etc. Playing Bhediya Aaya language game with them. Day 4, on fourth day, the beginning portion of the story with difficult words and asking them to guess the meaning from the context. On fifth day, working together on the word exercise given at the end of the chapter with the children. And on sixth day, working together with the children on the sentence level exercises given at the end of the chapter. Summary and analysis of the day-wise plan of Tulika. On first day, Tulika started teaching by asking children to talk about the animals they see in their surroundings. Then she wrote down the names of those animals on the board. Children saw the words written down on the board and wrote them down. Children started with pet animals first and then went on to talking about wild animals. She played a game with children after writing down all the words. In that game, children were asked to make the sound of the animal at one whose name she utters. Then she asked the names of the animals she wrote on the board. When she realized that children recognized the names of the animals, she told them to write them down on their copies. Then she asked children to draw the animals that they like and encircle the matching names. Tulika started taking rounds in the class as children got engaged with the activity given by her, and she helped children to finish the activity that got stuck in between. On second day, Tulika focused on the three pictures given in the story. She asked students to narrate what they see in the pictures. Children said that they saw two boys who were standing in the jungle. A bear was there and a boy was found on the tree. Then she asked children to narrate further about what they saw in the picture, such as what are boys doing, what the bear was doing, etc. Then she asked children to tell stories about the pictures they saw. The children hesitated first, but later on, they told many stories that they could possibly imagine about the pictures. Tulika appreciated all the stories and encouraged the children. Then Tulika told the children that she would read out the story for the children. Then she read the story aloud at a slow pace and loud voice. She told children to recognize what she reads by moving their fingers on them. Almost half the children were reading the story along with her in a soft voice. Those who still could not read listened to the story carefully. Tulika ensured that she made the sitting arrangements very well so that weak students could be helped. She made those children who could not read sit with the one who could read. She stopped when the two friends met the bear. Then she asked what might have happened when two friends were found in the jungle alone and they had nothing to fall back on. Children gave many possibilities. She wrote down all the predictions children gave on the board along with the names of the children. On third day, Tulika said, "Today, Tulika reads the story aloud again and again. She stopped where she had stopped before. She repeated the same process of making the children predict the end of the story and continued reading thereafter. Soon after completing the story, Tulika got into character analysis of the story in an exploratory mode. She asked questions such as, how did children like the behavior of the friends? What happened to the friendship if they were in the position of the other friend? What might they have done and the like?" Then she wrote the word Bhalu on the board and told students to encircle the word Bhalu from the story. Then she asked students to tell her how many times the word Bhalu occurred in the story. She repeated the same process with other frequently used words such as Gaon, Murda, etc. After the word recognition game, she started the Bhediaya game with the children. As per this game, all children were to act like a dead body and one child was supposed to act as Bhediya. Who comes to attack? Bhediya's job was to move around without touching the dead bodies. Children who had been asked to act like dead bodies were supposed to lie down on the floor like statues with eyes shut and straight face. Any child who would open the eyes or smile or deviate from the status posture was called as one of the game by Bhediya. Children took a while to understand the game. Once they understood the game, they started playing the game with all seriousness. They would lie down on the floor one after the other with the entire body shaking with suppressed giggles. Half the children started sneaking by, opening their eyes occasionally and smiling. In the first round, the game got over very soon. After a few rounds, children learned the game and it was not that easy to call game over so easily. On fourth day, Tulika takes different words. As she starts the class, she asks children to encircle difficult words found in the story. She wrote down all the difficult words found by the children on the board. She asked if anyone knew the meaning of any given word on the board and encouraged children to make sentences using the words. She then explained the meaning of difficult words to children and made them say sentences using the difficult words. On fifth day, Tulika worked together with children in solving the exercises given at the end of the chapter. In one of the exercises, children were asked to make words taking letters from a given word. Before taking up that exercise, Tulika first asked children to tell any two words. She wrote two words such as kursi and kitab on the board. She picked up first C from the first word and ta from the second word. Then she asked students what that makes when they combine these two letters. That was easy for the children, and from there they picked up the way to go ahead with the exercise. She called two, three children to the board to do exercise, and the rest of the children started doing the exercise on their copies. Tulika went to them and advised them to go over to the next exercise. Children began finding names of the animals that they already knew about and so on. After certain time, Tulika discussed the given exercise in the class. This was a tough task as the letters were not only to be picked, but they also had to be arranged in various orders to make meaningful words. After this exercise, she picked up the sixth exercise that expected children to select the most appropriate word for a given sentence. She read the sentences aloud and asked children to answer the questions by selecting the more suitable words. Then Tulika started the writing incomplete sentences on the board and encouraged children to complete those sentences. Most of the children did the exercise orally, whereas few wrote down on copies. The class got over as she was with the repeat process of the same exercise. On the sixth day, Tulika started sentences level exercise. First, she started with the question answer type exercises. She encouraged children to answer the question asked in the exercise. Some answered and some did not. She discussed the answer after excluding the answer from the student. She wrote down the best answer for each question on the board. The entire question answer exercise was completed this way and children copied them down on their notebooks. Tulika took rounds in the class to figure out whether the entire class was doing it effectively or not. She helped children with copying down the answer written on the board who found difficulty in copying them. She then moved into exercise which expect children to make sentences using a given words. She too got this exercise done through discussion first. She helped children to understand each and every word by taking multiple examples till they understand the words. Some children found it difficult to make sentences using words at the level of spelling. She wrote those words down on the board. Almost all the children could make sentences using 5 words at least. The class got over in the middle of this exercise. 3 words were left to be made sentences of which she gave as homework assignment. Let us conclude what we get from this. If we plan our lessons well, we can teach in a more systematic way. It is very important for us to know the background of the children, classroom situation, and background of the chapter theme to be able to make a successful lesson plan. At the primary level, children should be allowed to speak without any hesitation and use the languages they know. Children should participate actively in all classroom activities. One-way talk from the teacher may prove counterproductive. It is not necessarily true that children learn only that much what you plan to teach in a given class. Children have their own thought process and they employ that for learning, which is why it is important for you to engage them in thinking activities when you are preparing your lesson plan. Instead of finding our faults in every answer given by the children, the teacher must try to see what the children have done with the given questions when they have answered the question. It is not important to judge the learning through errors, but through acquisitions. The question a teacher should ask is, what is that a child has got right? Our focus, unfortunately, is always on mistakes. If the teacher can read the chapter 2-3 times before coming to the class, taking care of various activities and adjustments that may be needed in the class would be easy. Before making a lesson plan, the teacher must know the class size, age group of the children, classroom situation, students' background knowledge about the topic, etc. So, learners, we will meet you on our next lecture. Till then, thank you.